Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs video on Thermistor software design. In this video, we will cover lookup tables, the Steinhart-Hart equation, and a linear regression formula to start converting a thermistor output into temperature values. At the end, we'll talk about how to leverage a simple threshold detection to simplify your software design. When searching for a thermistor, you'll find that many manufacturers provide what is called a lookup table, also known as resistance to temperature table. These tables have traditionally been provided due to the nonlinearity of NTC thermistors. It includes the effective resistance values across temperature that can be expected from the device, typically in intervals of 1 or 5 degrees Celsius. In order to use the lookup table, the first step is to store known values in software. This includes the resistance and temperature values in a memory array, as well as other circuit values that will be used to calculate the thermistor's resistance. If using a voltage divider circuit, you would save the voltage bias, bias resistor, and ADC bit number values in memory. Remember, it is important to use the most precise components possible in order to minimize their impact on the temperature error. The next step is to set up your formula to calculate the voltage drop across the thermistor. As your code is running, you will have a changing ADC count value in least significant bits, but we need to translate that into a voltage. In order to do so, you need to know how much voltage corresponds to one LSB in your specific ADC. To find the voltage per ADC LSB, divide the bias voltage in the circuit by the total number of LSB bits in your ADC, which is 2 to the power of ADC bits. From there, you can multiply this known value by the changing ADC count to find the voltage drop across the thermistor at that point in time. Now that we have the voltage drop across the thermistor, we can use a simple equation derived from the well-known voltage divider formula to calculate the effective resistance value of the thermistor. Continuing with V-temp from the previous example, we find that the resistance of the thermistor is 6.893 kiloohms. Now that your code has stored the thermistor's resistance value in a variable, it can then step through your lookup table by using a loop starting at the beginning of the table until the resistance value we just calculated for the thermistor is less than the resistance stored in your lookup table. This example is for a linear PTC and would return the temperature value of negative 35 degrees Celsius. From there, your system can then use this temperature value to take any actions you have specified in software. As mentioned before, this is a very simple method to convert temperature, but it relies heavily on rounding between elements in the lookup table. So what if you didn't want to round, but instead wanted more decimal places in the resulting temperature? Well, whether you are using a 1 or 5 degrees Celsius lookup table, you can use a linear interpolation between two rows in the table to calculate a more accurate temperature value. This method works very well with linear PTC thermistors due to their linear characteristic across temperature. It uses the equation on the right to calculate how far the measured resistance value is from the closest resistance values in the lookup table. Then it applies that same ratio to the corresponding two temperature values in order to approximate and return a more accurate temperature in a floating point notation. While lookup tables are indeed convenient, they introduce error in that they approximate temperature at given steps and only include a set number of significant figures. Another popular method of calculating temperature for thermistors is through the use of Steinhart-Hart equation. In order to set up the equation, you need to pre-calculate some values and store them in memory. Using the lookup table provided by the manufacturer, you can calculate L1, 2, and 3, as well as Y1, 2, and 3. Keep in mind, this linear PTC version of the Steinhart-Hart equation uses temperature in degrees Kelvin, so you need to convert from Celsius to Kelvin first. In order to accurately characterize the resistance to temperature curve, you need to pick 3 points across temperature. In this example, we picked negative 40, 25, and 150 degrees Celsius because we want to use the thermistor across its whole operating temperature range. Next, gamma 2 and 3 need to be calculated from the Y and L values to finally be able to calculate your static coefficients A, B, and C. That is all that is needed to set up the Steinhart-Hart equation. During operation, 1 over the temperature in degrees Kelvin is equal to A plus B times the natural log of the resistance of the thermistor plus C times the natural log of the resistance of the thermistor quantity cubed. Compared to the lookup table method, there is no loop in code that you would have to design, but you still need to go through the steps of calculating the thermistor's resistance value. Another method to calculate temperature is called the fourth order polynomial regression. Similar to the previous two methods, the regression formula still requires the thermistor's resistance value as it is used multiple times in the equation. Additionally, coefficients A0 through A4 need to be pre-calculated and stored in memory. Not all linear PTC manufacturers provide these coefficients, but the thermistor design tool on TI.com automatically calculates these coefficients for TI's linear thermistor portfolio. This equation is the most accurate method for linear PTC thermistors and is up to 10 times faster than the Steinhart-Hart equation due to simpler mathematics. NCC thermistors are not able to use this equation because of their nonlinear resistance characteristic over temperature, whereas it approximates the linear PTC thermistor curve very well. As we've seen with the previous examples, it takes a few calculations in order to obtain the resulting temperature. However, if you're able to save the ADC count in memory for certain temperatures that you care about, then you would eliminate the need to calculate the voltage across the thermistor, the effective resistance of the thermistor, and the temperature value. This means that it doesn't matter what value you are tracking as long as you know what temperature that corresponds to beforehand. Using the ADC count would be the quickest method. For example, let's say that once our system temperature crosses 85 degrees Celsius, we want a fan to turn on and stay on until the temperature goes back down to 75 degrees. You could calculate the temperature, as we did in the previous methods, over and over again to compare the calculated temperature to 85 and 75 degrees, or you could save time by storing the ADC count values for 75 and 85 degrees Celsius in memory and compare the raw ADC count in a simple if statement instead. As temperature rises, the system does not take any action to cool down, but once the raw ADC count is greater than or equal to 9,656, then the fan turns on. The fan stays on until the raw ADC count is less than or equal to 9,428, and once it reaches that value, the fan turns off. This is a simple threshold detection method similar to how a thermostat works. Not many manufacturers specify these values, but they are pre-calculated for you in TI's thermistor design tool. To summarize, there are multiple methods to convert the output across a thermistor to a temperature value in software. One of the most common methods is to use a lookup table, which is normally provided by the thermistor manufacturer and comes in either a 1 or 5 degrees Celsius step size. If choosing to use a lookup table, one recommendation is to do a linear interpolation between 2 points to output a temperature that is within 2 rows of your lookup table for more accuracy. The Steinhart-Hart equation is an accurate method of temperature conversion for NTC thermistors, and a good option if you want to reduce memory and don't want to loop through a lookup table. However, it will require the natural logarithm function in order to perform the calculations. The number one recommended conversion method for linear PTCs is called the fourth order polynomial regression equation. Polynomial equations are the most accurate way to get a temperature from a linear PTC thermistor due to its basic math functions. It is up to 10 times faster than the Steinhart-Hart equation. If you only care about a few temperature points, consider calculating what the expected ADC count is at those temperatures and use those values to compare against the raw ADC count. This will save a lot of conversion time and would require the least amount of memory. Thank you for watching this video on thermistors. For more information, please visit ti.com/thermistors and download the thermistor design tool, which provides automatic calculations and example C code to help you get started with the temperature conversion methods shown here today.